Hey guys, with Abomination 9 here, back playing some more Monster Hunter Online. We left off, we were fighting the... I've already forgotten, oh, the spider. Not the spider, the scorpion, which I don't remember his name, so we'll call him Skarner. Like Skarner from League of Legends. And today's video might be a little bit off because I might be quiet, because I have too many fans going, so I've turned the mic down. But yeah, whatever. I'm using a ice greatsword, though I don't think his weakest element is ice. I'm just using it because I'm pretty sure everyone's tired of the lance, because I use the lance a lot. And I use the bow often too. I haven't used a greatsword in a while, so I'm going to use this since it's another high tier weapon that I have. And I'm pretty sure this is Ian Garuga. I'm like 90% sure. This is Garuga, because it looks like him. A purple dragon. Or a purple, Wavern, I should say. We're just getting thrown in. This is another new map. Yeah, this is a new map. What the heck, Stonehenge out there? You see that? On the mini-map. So, if I remember correctly, Garuga is the combination of a Kutku and I don't know, like a Rathalos or something mating, I think. So like those two different species mating together, kind of like a mule, I guess. But yeah, there's a bunch of what appear to be rock structures here on this part. I don't know what the heck's up with that. Also, no one's here with me, so it's just me going in by myself against Garuga. Maybe we should do a little bit of exploring, because again, this is another new area, another new map we haven't got to before. They keep throwing a lot of maps. I think there's a decent handful at this point. More than the games usually have, minus, well, the third series, anyways. What the? This is a normal blue Kutku? It's a blue Kutku. To Garuga, check out blue? That's crazy. Because blue, I find him so annoying. I hated fighting him at all. But I guess Garuga's supposed to be, like, super bad. Garuga. I want to go check out Stonehenge over there. So far it's been pretty plain here. It's just no normal foresty mountainy area. I wish they would bring the old maps from the other games, because that was like my favorite part. Like going into like the second game was seeing another dead blue. What the heck? Was to see the other maps come from the old game. It really made me happy when the other maps showed up in the second game. Yeah, let's go to Stonehenge. Also, I have to say this map is at least more optimized than the other maps. Despite having such like far landscapes. Okay, so it's just like a bunch of pile of rocks, though I'm assuming maybe they can all be destroyed if you're fighting something here. So Garuga's not here. I don't know if using a greatsword either was a good idea. Depending on how fast Garuga is. Because it's been quite a time since I fought Garuga. Probably since, like, the first gen. I probably fought him in the second one. I don't know. Okay, we got Old Man here. How about you tell me where Garuga is? We're supposed to be fighting, so I know we have a fight. This might just be a rappel mission. Oh, here he is. What, he's just gonna ignore us? Just seem to be pretty fast. Okay, that's like, I don't know, an Ian-ish move there. Since I'm poisoned. Also, I probably shouldn't be using my antidote for this. I'm gonna wait until I know he's not focusing me. Though I think the cat left. So yeah, this got me hit because he left. And again, that's an Ian Los move. Well, I think that's more of an Ian. So is it a Kutcu and an Ian? That seems a bit weird. Like, I could see like maybe like a Rathalos and a Kutcu, but not an Ian and a Kutcu. Oh, cool. That's kind of Rathalos-ish, like screaming in the air. So I decided to use a VPN in this video to try to connect, and it seems to be worse. Like, the latency is clearly worse, but I guess maybe the stability is overall better. Maybe I need to find like a better place to connect to. Crud, I wanted to block, my thumb accidentally pressed the attack button. Oh, look at that. That was a cool animation. Cat just made him mad. Oh man, barely. Very fast. Oh man, barely dodged that. So though he has like mostly Ian moves, but the screaming in the air thing I think is a Los move. Okay, now he's actually doing some Kutcu stuff. He likes to touch down faster than Ian, at least from the third gen. I haven't fought her in the fourth. I haven't played in the fourth game since they're on the 3DS. Though I have a 3DS, I have the original small version, so I just never really wanted to play Monster Hunter on such a small device, or one that doesn't have like two analogs. Oh, I actually blocked that one. Oh, he still hit me even though I blocked it. Which is a problem. Fall down, please. This is your third one. This is where you fall down, yeah. Is he leaving? It looks like he's like actually leaving. My lock-on went away. He's in front of Stonehenge. Pretty sure we can cut that tail off, not that I've tried. I like that. I like the fact that he like tries to keep his composure. Ah, the stupid air. I couldn't get the slice off, so I was affected by the air. If I would have just pulled the sword out, it would have counted. Crud, I missed. And then he's gonna come out for Poison Claws, yeah. So he's kind of like, I feel like he's a better combination of the two, because he, of, not necessarily two, all three of the species that you could like connect him to. Because he, like, he has Ian's Fireballs, he has like Rathalos's Sky Scream. I think he screams in the air, right? I don't think Ian does that. He has poison claws, he has poison tail. He has Kutcu's normal fireballs that seem to be a little bit better. Whoa, what the? Bounced off? It was just slicing through perfectly fine before. Oh, come on, seriously, like, moves like an inch to the side and I just left the area. I would assume, like, the only problem with this version of this amalgamation Chimera beast here is that, his health is probably lower than them. Well, not Cutku, but has to be higher than Cutku's. But lower than Ian and Los. Looks like I have to put a lot of force into that, otherwise I can't cut through. I need to hold it down. Oh my god, I love that so much. The model, it just is so good. The heck, did he hurt himself? Like he hurt himself falling down. And he can quick roar too. Which almost gave him the ability to hit me. Of course I was gonna bounce off. I need to actually charge it up. Can I uppercut? Oh crud, I let it hit me. That was like half damage and poison. Whoops. Oh, he's got me. Oh, no, he went to the cat. Yeah, much more annoying than Blue, I would have to say. Well, I don't know, I wouldn't say annoying, just much faster. Unless he's feral or something. Because there are feral versions, I would assume, in this game. So I've come across, like, in the story mode. Versions of monsters that kind of like blood all over them, maybe like a little bit of battle scarring, and I just call them feral, like feral versions of myself. Cred, I don't know where he's going. So I don't know if this is like a feral Ian Garuga, and that's why he's so fast. Okay, we could kind of see him land over there. The only area over there is this place, but like I have noticed, the map isn't too accurate. Accurate, what the heck? Accurate. So even though he just landed... He landed, what, right there? In the middle of nowhere? So I guess, we're just gonna have to guess where he went. Because he didn't fly, there's none of these other places he could get to. The other places, like, spawn. Like, the closest place, to his area of landing was spawn. Monsters can't go to spawn. Watch, he's like in. Wait, I think I can hear him. He might be in here. Maybe? No? No, he's not in here. The only place he could be is one then. Unless he was behind a pillar in Stonehenge area. And didn't get line of sight on me. Okay, so he is in here. The last place I check, as usual. I think they hit him in the wing. I want to use my special, but I don't know if I can. Crud. I think that's fine. I have to assume a pitfall could work on him. I don't remember. It has to, right? Yeah, it did. And I'm just going to go into my ultimate. Okay, that broke my sharpness twice? Or once? He's pretty mad. I kind of want to sharpen my weapon. Yeah, that had to break it twice, right? So yeah, I'm just gonna bail real quick so I can sharpen. Whoa. Everything just like unloaded. You can hear him fighting the cat. He's at the door, so I probably should run. That was a mistake. Though he didn't capitalize on it. Or he couldn't, because I was too far away. Okay, so I can like quick slash the tip. Also, I really like this greatsword. I really like the way it looks. Ugh, dang it, I hate that I have to charge it full. There's not enough time to do that. Oh, we traded. I wanted to jump, but wait, why is that on fire? When did all this stuff become on fire? Okay, there's more stage hazards. Like, I realized that there was, an avalanche that could happen in the tundra area. Oh, you got your poison and paralysis plants. You got, no, I guess I should just go to spawn. You got the poison puddles in the swamp that can, well, obviously poison you, but I was gonna say there's also the other puddles that are just normal water, but if poison gets tossed into them, they become poisonous puddles. Now we have burning grass. Okay, see if this, he lost his composure. Oh my god, keep it together, man, so I can actually hit you. Oh my god, please, stop tripping. Now it's actually getting annoying. Since I can't actually hit his tail anymore because he keeps tripping. Oh my god, I've missed like every shot. I should just focus on hitting him at this point. Okay, that was a nice slice. But I don't think I'm gonna be able to cut it off in this video. Crud. Okay, that was a good slice. Doesn't feel like it's gonna come off. Simply because I just haven't invested enough time into cutting it. Oh, he's almost dead at least. He's not painted though, so now we're gonna go on a wild goose chase. He went that way, which means almost nothing, but we'll go to Stonehenge first. Okay, look like he went over there. If he would have went to Stonehenge, we would have been able to see him, I guess, so that's probably like the best example of being able to see into another area. Is that you can actually just see Stonehenge right there. So if there's a monster wandering around, you could easily see them. Because there's a lot of areas that you can't actually see into, and there's some you can. And that's like the best example of a place that you can see into. I feel like I heard him walking. So I'm gonna go try 2 first, and then 4. Okay, Okay, don't go back. That'd be a waste of time. Like, every time I get next to this area, it sounds like there's something in there. I think that's the problem. I keep just getting tricked. No, he isn't here. Actually. Please hit the tail, not the wing. It hit the wing! That was bad. Of course it hits the freaking wing. I should have backed up. Or just not even, like, committed to it. Well, that was a slice. That was really quick. I can't believe he's not dead yet. I've had some nice slices on him. Oh, he actually didn't fall that time. Or stumble. Oh, we got him. But I accidentally clicked through the freaking death scene, because I don't know why this game has every button allow you to do that. Also, what were all the things I was supposed to do? Is that just all the... I didn't even notice all these things I cleared right there. Like, what the heck? And that was a long fight. 23 minutes, 22 minutes. Hopefully there's like some good stuff to mine in here, or gather. I have a decent amount of space. Is that Macolite? I know this area was okay. I mean, I like all these different areas, but nothing really stood out. I mean, like, the waterscape was pretty cool. And just, like, to be able to look out and see all that stuff. I don't know. I still haven't seen a volcano. That's the problem. Where's the freaking volcano? I don't have fire herb. I would assume I have to get fire herb from the volcano. Where's the freaking volcano? So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Tune into the next episode. Like, subscribe, comment. You need to do. See ya.